This video was originally meant to be just a part of a full hunt in which we would take a loadout consisting of nothing but handguns to Silver Ridge Peaks. However, as soon as this happened, I knew it had to be its own thing. Of course, it's gonna be way harder to get him now that he's spooked, but I really would like to get him with the 45 or the Glock, and I guess he just continued down through there? If we can just figure out where he's headed and maybe where he slows down at, we can either cut him off when he comes back to his zone or potentially get out ahead of him, because other than catching him nervous in, I think, a rest zone, I'm not really sure what we do from here. That's our guy. Man, at that angle, he looks really solid. Up to 108 is good, but that's not the biggest set of horns. But if he'll just stop out in there and we can make a determination as to what direction he's going to go in, if he's going to come back, if he's just going to wander off in the distance, that would be nice just to know where to go from here. I thought he might stop. He's been going for forever, but I guess maybe we spooked him a second time right when he started coming across there. So he is nervous, and he's kind of maybe coming back. He's more so going north, about 270 out. Let's mark that and try to get around this lake and cut him off, because I'm guessing he's going to end up out in this field, but he's going to have to go pretty slow for us to get ahead of him. Oh, he's right there. Man, I did not realize he's uneven, and he's alarmed. If we can just kind of hang out here, that's doable range for the Glock. I want to go 45, but I mean, with the wind, if we can just get him in the open at 100 meters, I'd say we go for that. And of course, he's just perfectly behind that tree. He's down to alert. I don't know if I'd want to take that shot. Back to alarmed. I say if he gets out into the open, we go for it. Man, is that the same one? He's alert immediately again. It's 90 meters. I say we give it a try. Definitely hit him. Did we hit him well? Because we can hit him a second time if needed. And he just went down right there. That had to have been a long shot. I don't think that's the right pronghorn. I never looked at the estimate, but I don't think that's the same one. Wait. It's a dark fur type? I didn't even realize it. I've never gotten a dark fur type diamond pronghorn, and he's uneven. But not necessarily in the worst way. 100.5 score, 63.9 kilo. I'm confident that's not the right one. There's another we gotta go and figure out. So it's at this point where things really went off the rails. I genuinely never saw the player in blue there on the map. I was just fixated on going and getting the tracks and finding that pronghorn, because as far as I was concerned, that was a really good one. And obviously his tracks were right there. He had gotten through there and I never knew it. And honestly, I don't know how. It never was in view. Maybe it was just on our way up the hill he skirted through there. I don't know. But the events that followed were wild. That might be a problem. I think someone may have found our pronghorn. We'll just kind of not run, because I mean, we already got a diamond anyway, but I didn't even know they were over there. Is that actually even... Yeah, I'd say that's it. So probably we're just going to not get that one. But honestly, Diamond Dark is the pronghorn I've always wanted. So I guess of the two, we got the better one. At this point, I'm invested. We've been tracking this pronghorn for a while. I keep on seeing him spotting it. I know he's going to take a shot at it, and I just want to watch and see what happens. And all of a sudden, oh, I think he missed it. Man, maybe that was just multiplayer. I'm just gonna watch. Just in case anything happens, if that pronghorn's still alive, at least I'll have an idea of what's going on. Is not dead though, there's no hunting pressure, so I mean, worst case, we'll just go help the guy, but He hasn't said anything in chat. Hopefully he doesn't think I'm chasing his thing, because we're kind of here first. After maybe 5 minutes, he was getting pretty far ahead of me, and I wanted to just go and look for tracks, see if I could find blood, and kind of direct him in the correct direction. And then, as I open the map, he leaves. And on the off chance that you're watching this right now, and you're the person in this video, I'm going to blur your name so you don't have to worry about anything like that, but I didn't get the chance to find anything out. So it was back to trying to understand where on earth this pronghorn went, because nothing made sense. I never did find any tracks from where he had shot, and of course I didn't have it marked, so that didn't really help. I think that's gotta be R5, and it's been quite a lengthy track. And if he's that close, maybe we can still pull off a 45 kill, but it is not exactly forgiving in here. Pretty brushy. He could be 10 meters away and we wouldn't see him right now. Oh, he's right there. 40 meters away. If we can just get an opening where maybe we can get that shot, I'd like him to stand still like that. Maybe if he'll do that again right through here. Just need one more step, and he definitely knows we're here. If he'll do that again, maybe just the other side of these trees, we could go for that. That fell back, and that was way late. He's going down though, so I think we must have gotten back of the lungs or liver, and we'll watch this reload animation on a camouflage 45 as we run up here. We must have gotten so lucky, because that felt borderline intestines. But another level 5 pronghorn down. This guy is a 102.21 diamond, actually bigger than the last, and that was definitely too far back. Caught the back of the lungs anyway, and the liver, but that could have been really bad. I mean, after all that happened, 3.5 kilometer tracking distance, nearly losing him, it would have been tragic if we messed that up. So that is why we ended up taking the handguns to Parque Fernando, because after this happened, I felt like it would have been weird to then take them to Silver Ridge Peaks again, because there was no way we were going to top this encounter, this experience. But I actually haven't put them in the lodge. If you watched really closely in the handgun video we did do on Parque, you may have noticed the pronghorn in the trophy manager as spoilers, so I'm actually looking forward to going back and finally placing them in the lodge. I mean, it really was just one of the craziest experiences I've had in Call of the Wild in general, let alone Call of the Wild multiplayer. To find the wrong level 5 pronghorn, end up taking that out with the Glock, and it's a dark fur type. The fur type I've always wanted a diamond of, and I didn't even... it never registered to me as we were spotting it that it was, or I probably wouldn't have taken that shot. And then, you know, it's a little unfortunate that it's uneven and stuff, but it's not that bad. Like, I could see it being feasible in real life, so it's in this spot. Actually, that doesn't look half bad, kind of hides a bit of it. But this used to be the location of my favorite diamond pronghorn. It had basically the same horns, but a little bit smaller than the second one that we got. And that was just... I don't think I've ever experienced that in Call of the Wild multiplayer. Like, at first it was like, is this guy trying to steal my diamond? And then I don't actually think he knew we were there, or maybe he did, I have no idea. But just hopefully, if you're watching this, if you were the one in that scenario, or if you've ever been in that scenario, hopefully I had nothing to do with, ended up leaving or rushing the shot or anything like that. I just wanted to watch, and it ended up being completely crazy like that. But a 102.2 score for him, and it was back-to-back diamond pronghorns, nothing in between, and just a wild, wild encounter out there on Silver Ridge Peaks. So, as I said, it had to be made into its own video, and actually, Parque went fantastic. We ended up getting a really nice diamond mule deer in the process. That is literally right over here. So it worked out for the best that we ended up going back to another map with the handgun loadout and getting something good there. So all of a sudden, we've killed 3 really cool diamonds with handguns, all because of one video idea that led to 2 diamonds and then an extra video. But anyway, I think that is going to do it for this video. So as always, thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time.